Now to California drought coverage. Today, the first day of mandatory water rationing for 90,000 water customers in Santa Cruz. So how did people in the so-called water police handle the first day? Action News reporter Phil Gomez is live in Santa Cruz right now. Phil.
Well, Dan, they go by many names, water enforcement, water cops, drought busters, but whatever you want to call them, their main job is to make sure water users aren't wasting water as we head into an indefinite water rationing season. There's two full and two part-time city employees who drive around looking for water waste. Their job isn't necessarily to stick violators with a citation. It's to make sure customers know we're in a drought and water is a precious commodity.
We don't hand out tickets. We make a genuine effort to make contact with the customer. We will document it. And that's just used for our own purposes if we need to proceed with a violation.
One of the challenges facing the water department is that many of their customers are vacation homeowners, so they're not always home when a water leak is detected, or may not even know water rationing has been declared.
We have a lot of vacation rentals, a lot of vacation homes, and that being said, these people aren't always around to see what's going on, so if we could be out there and we could provide them with that information.
So these just screw into your faucet.
Okay.
But the word is out. If long lines at the water department are any indication, customers are coming in and stocking up water conservation tools.
I've cut back like crazy on watering outside. I have a whole lot of roses in my yard, like 119. They're going to have to live with less water.
Beginning Thursday, each home with four or fewer people is allotted 249 gallons a day. If you go 10% over, it's an extra $25 on your bill and $50 for each 10% over that. That's pretty easy to do if you're not careful.
It's a necessary evil, I think. It'll take folks a while to get accustomed to it.
Landscaping will take a hit. Several restrictions are in place, including no watering between 10 a.m. and 5 p.m. And all hoses must have a shut-off nozzle.
What we're seeing is a lot of interest and commitment on behalf of the community.
And those of you who may have spot water waste, the city has established a leak line that you can call. It's 420-LEAK. Again, that number, 420-LEAK. Dan?
All right. Thank you very much, Phil.